right, everybody, I've got something special for us to talk about and take a look at today, and that is going to be the Type A 13 7-inch rifle. And this is everything but just another rifle in the market. This is a very purpose-built and performance-driven setup here. Everything from full ambient controls, fully adjustable gas system, provides you options that most of us have to turn to the aftermarket for in a factory build. So we are going to break this rifle down in detail from the forged receiver group to that range experience, so you get a really good idea of what the Type A is all about. I have personally been waiting almost a year to test this specific rifle out since I first got to run these in Texas, like at the very beginning of the year. So it's been a long time coming. Before we get into all the specs and everything on this, we have got to pay the bills real quick here with the help of today's sponsor, and that is HRT Tactical. Now, HRT Tactical brings you all of those soft goods for your hard lifestyle out there. Everything from the new ARC belt system to the L-back plate carrier. They pretty much have you covered when you are looking for gear zine pouches. This is the gear that I personally carry and trust both at home and at work. Well, let's go ahead and get right into the specs on this Type A Pro rifle here, because it really matters when it comes to this build. And then we're gonna talk about that range experience, both suppressed, unsuppressed, everything that I noticed out there, especially when it comes down to the trigger and all of the components that went into this build. All right, we're gonna take a good look at everything the Type A has to offer, and I might talk a little fast because we've got a lot of stuff to go over. So from the buttstock to the business end here, let's go ahead and begin with the furniture. We've got that B5 system SOP mod style stock on here. I love this, easy to adjust, has that nice triangular cheek weld section. I'm a huge fan of that, some of my favorite stuff of all time. You'll also get the B5 systems grip, far less of an aggressive angle, great texture all over the sides and the front. Hands down, again, one of my favorite pieces of furniture. We're gonna get that QD backplate from Type A, which is a big plus. I always like to have not only QDs in the rear of the stock, but also in the rear of the receiver. I'm just used to running them where, right there, whether it's a single point or a two-point sling. I just like to have the options either way it is. We will get an ambi charging handle. This is BG Defense or Type A's charging handle. You can see very nicely radius, no hard edges all the way around there. Has that nice high edge right there, so it helps with gas a little bit if you're running a suppressor. Overall solid, ambidextrous. You can work it from either side. Gonna do everything you need it to do. It's standard and it is very, very nice. Now when it comes to the receiver set, the lower receiver here, as you can see, we'll talk more about all the small parts in there, and the upper receiver right here. Both of these are going to be forged 7075 T611 aluminum, and they're going to do absolutely everything you are going to need those things to do out on the range. When it comes to the controls on the lower receiver here, you're going to have an ambidextrous 70 or 90 degree choice. You can change the stubby side over if you're right-handed, left-handed, and you can go to a full 90. That is completely up to you. Gives you the choice, and again, another great options. They use improved pins here, both front and rear, for the takedown and the pivot pin, which are their design, and they make this receiver fit extremely tight with the upper on there. And I love a tight setup, and I know most of you do as well. They're gonna be zero movement. Now this is going to be a 100% ambi lower receiver. Whether it comes to your bolt release right here on your standard left side as you would run this, you're also going to have a right-sided bolt release here, so you can literally run this with your trigger finger, whether it's the mag release or the bolt release. Now if you're a lefty, this is where this really becomes awesome, because you have your bolt release, you also have your mag release on this side, so you can truly run this the way that you should be able to if all ARs were designed in an ambidextrous configuration. So the lefties are getting a lot of love here on this one. When it comes to the trigger you're going to get with this, it's going to be a two-stage trigger. So you can see that initial stage take up while the safety is on. And then once we go to pull it, that first stage, very clean break and reset right here. So nice setup. You're going to get an extended trigger guard down here, which makes it very nice. Also, it's been well beveled, both the front and the rear side of that trigger guard, which is very nice, because as you go to move your finger in, you're going to slide right off. That also is a huge help when you are wearing gloves, so you don't catch here up in the front or here in the rear, depending on whether you're left-handed or right-handed. So very nice touch there as well. Also have a little bit, as you can see right there, of flare to that magwell. That's gonna help you if you're a little bit off on those magazine exchanges, give you a little bit more area to get that magazine in there and get that thing back up and running. Now, when it comes to the upper receiver here, it's going to be a T-marked upper 1913 rail all the way across the top. That will follow through all the way through the end of the rail. They have several different rail designs. This one is M-lock all the way around. So this M-lock rail, very nice. You can see we have plenty of fasteners on this. We have a total of 6 all the way around, which is gonna help with rigidity, strength, anti-rotation, all that good stuff you would expect from a rifle in this class. So the lines of this thing also, if you haven't been paying attention to that, machine work is immaculate. And the fit of the receiver, the fit of the rail, everything is just top notch. Okay, let's go ahead and talk about those guts in the way of the bolt and carrier group here. As you can see, not your average bolt and carrier group just from taking a quick glance at it. So the carrier itself, the main body, this is 8620 steel, which is very well known and very well respected when it comes to bolt and carrier groups. Gonna do everything you need it to do. The firing pin in there is 17.4 PH. This is an M16 style cut, so you get that full mass. And if you have the third hole or the giggle switch, it's gonna do everything that you need this to do. When it comes to the coating on here, the carrier is rem polished and then titanium nitride coated. So basically, it's polished to a high standard, completely deburred, and then they coat it with titanium nitride. So this is gonna have the ultimate in lubricity properties in that Rockwell hardness, and it's just gonna stay looking good for a long time and be super easy to clean. The gas keys on here, you can see, are properly staked and they are hydraulic staked. Very nice job on those as well. And you've got hardened USGI specifications here and grade 8 hardware. So your screws in here are grade 8. That is very important when it comes to a bolt and carrier, because those two are the only things holding that key on there. And if you lose this key, your gas systems goes down and you are done. When it comes to the bolt itself, it's Carpenter 158. That's that steel that everybody loves and looks for in a bolt and carrier group. That was the military choice for the contract. Magnetic particle inspected, high pressure tested, QPQ nitrided. It's gonna do everything and more that almost all of us are gonna need it to do out there in real life or on the range. Every critical component of this bolt and carrier group has been coated with what they call their advanced nitride process. Basically, it's gonna do everything any of us are gonna need it to do out there. This upper receiver, to get back to the gas system, is a mid-length upper receiver. So we are gonna have the durability, reliability, and softest shooting gas system we can with that mid-length setup, unless you want a big long one and go with a rifle. As you can see right up in there, it is finished off with a superlative gas block. That is their bleed-off, fully adjustable gas system, so you can set and forget this thing, run it suppressed, run it unsuppressed, minimizes the gas, minimizes wear and tear, everything you're looking for in here. That barrel is going to be a 416R stainless, finished in matte. Very nice look to it. 1-7 twist, 5.56. They do have other offerings from 300 Blackout, 5.56, 223. All of those things are available. Now, I know that was a lot of specs to go over, but it really does matter when it comes to a kind of purpose-built, custom-built rifle like this, because all of those small things in the design and the parts they use and the materials they use really make a big difference in how this thing performs out on the range. Now, the first couple of trips out to the range with this thing, I was really just running it to get a feel for it, how it was gonna run both suppressed and how it was gonna run unsuppressed with that fully adjustable gas system in there. Now, being this has that superlative bleed-off gas block, you have to adjust this into the ammo you are using. And once you get it set, you're gonna be good to go. When it comes to adjusting that, I personally adjust it for the lowest powered ammo I have, so it'll run both suppressed and non-suppressed, and then I find that I really never have to mess with it again. I do have to say, being able to adjust gas in the front is definitely nicer than having to slow things down in the rear, whether you're adding springs or H2 or H3 buffers, stuff like that. Overall, it's gonna run better, it's gonna run with less gas, the wear and tear in your parts are gonna be less, and the overall feel of it is just gonna be far superior than running a ton of gas up front and having to slow it down in the rear. The trigger that comes in the Type A is very nice. Now, most of my viewers know I'm a huge fan of single stage triggers. This is a two-stage design, but everything from the shoe and how it functions is extremely nice. You can run this thing very flat and you can run it very fast with that trigger. The overall feel of the recoil impulse on this, whether you are just shooting straight or whether you're transitioning from target to target, is immediately noticeable and very nice. Since you're able to control the gas up front, you're not getting as much of that gas pushed through the system. So with all the weight from the bolt, everything going on in the buffer tube, you're not getting as much of that feel. It's gonna stay much flatter, and you're not getting excess gas blown up in your face, especially if you are running it suppressed. That was one of the things I noticed when I initially got to test these in Texas, was instant that the recoil was different and less than a lot of other things that I have been able to use out there. They do offer a couple of different rails. This is the straight M-lock version. They have versions with QD all around the front end and the rear section. I will say, even though it's a more slim design as you're running this, whether you're running it really hard suppressed or without, there's plenty of heat standoff. There is a ton of M-lock all over this rail for everything you want to put on it, no matter what it is, as long as it's M-lock. So overall, very well done on that as well. The fully ambidextrous controls are very nice and well thought out. Everything from the design of the charging handle and how it's kind of radiused, got that texture up front and in the rear for grabbing it from either side. You've got your bolt release right here, mag release. And then on the opposite side, you're gonna have these same controls in a very nice location for you lefties. So whether you're right-handed, wrong-handed, lefties are finally getting the love they want and deserve. When it comes to the furniture on the Type A, I am a huge fan of B5 systems. They've given us that SOP mod style stock, so you get a really good cheek weld on it. It just fits me better. And of course, the B5 systems grip. So much less of an aggressive grip angle than like the A2 style that's way out here and kind of hurts your wrist. I love that. Much better for a straight up kind of shooting style. And of course, it's got a very nice texture on the front and on the sides. B5s is something I have trusted for years. I've got it on a ton. My favorite, maybe on just about the stock and the grip. There are some things I like better other times, but you cannot go wrong with B5 systems in any stretch of the imagination. Now, as of the filming of this initial video for this, because there's definitely going to be more, I am just under 1,000 rounds. And once I got it adjusted into my ammo, whether it was suppressed or unsuppressed, I have not had a single hiccup. No ammo had issues on it. I shot regular kind of 55 grain. I shot self-defense ammo through this. I didn't don't buy steel unless I really have to readjust it. Once I did my initial settings, whether it was suppressed or unsuppressed, it's just been a tank so far. And in all those rounds I have fired so far, it just feels like a tank. It feels solid. What I mean by that is when you are running this, whether you're running it super fast or just one shot at a time, it feels solid all throughout. You're not getting any of that weird rattle, especially out of the receiver set. I mean, it's just, there is zero movement in here between the machine work and how they've redone the pins here in the front and the rear. It feels like a one solid piece setup here. And I've said that about a couple of other rifles in the past in the same kind of price and quality category, but there's just such a big difference. You're not getting any rattle or wobble or any weird spring feeling or buffer feelings in here. It's just extremely smooth and solid. Let's get down to cash money American. What is this gonna cost us? And remember, this ain't no basic B rifle, hence the name Type A. So the way this one is set up here, this is the Pro, the 13.7. There's a couple of different options for colors. If you want some exotic color, that's gonna be on you. With the B5 systems, ambi controls, obviously no optic or anything. You're coming in at $2,099. That's the MSRP on the website. And I know some people might be like, well, that's a little bit expensive. Let's remember the level that we're at here in this rifle and kind of talk about the cost breakdown on a couple of these items. First, we're getting a fully ambi setup here from the safety, the charging handle, the bolt release, the magazine release, 100% ambidextrous. So lefties, righties, does not matter. If you want to run it all from the right side, you can. If you want to run it all from the left side, you can. And most rifles out there are not ambidextrous because it's very expensive to design them. And obviously there's a lot more parts going into it. We also have that fully adjustable bleed off gas system up front in the way of that superlative block. Those are definitely not cheap, so look those up. But that really seems to be the way a lot of companies are going, and I'm just a huge fan of adjustables. And last but not least is going to be that custom trigger right there that comes in this. So that's an accessory that many of us put on our rifles once we get them or rebuild them or do whatever. And triggers like this are going to run you generally in the range of $200+. There are some cheaper brands out there, but when you get into the really nice ones, plan on spending about $200 to $300. So bear that in mind when we're talking about an overall cost. So thinking about the way this is built, the materials, everything that's gone in it, the B5 furniture on it, which I'm a huge fan of, When we start breaking that down, you're probably never gonna have to replace or want to replace something on here since it's giving you everything out of the box until you literally wear the barrel out. And I just don't think most people are gonna do that. I've got several rifles that I've done it on, but I shoot like 5 times as much as most people do. So that original barrel is probably gonna last you a very long time. And that's a part that's considered a wearable anyways. And the last thing we'll talk about, because it kind of goes into that price category, is wait times or lead time. So these are not off the shelf rifles. They custom build these to your order. So you have to understand, it's not like they just pick one off the shelf and send it to you. You're gonna order, they're gonna put that order in a queue, and then they're going to build your rifle. And people want these rifles and people want them bad. So they have no shortage of orders, but they will let you know what an expected lead time is, and they generally will kind of keep you informed as to where the process is out. What I will say though is, since they're doing a custom build for you, expect a wait time and expect it to be from weeks to maybe a couple of months. I don't know where it's at, you can check with them, but I know that is a process that happens anytime you're getting a full custom build that's just not off the shelf, so be prepared. Well, we're gonna go ahead and close out the initial video on this Type A Pro rifle right here. Make sure you give me some love down in the comments sections. Let me know your thoughts and what you think about this rifle up front, or if you've heard about BG Defense Type A before. I had, and once I run it, I knew I had to get one for the channel here. Make sure you guys subscribe, hit the bell notification. All that stuff is a huge help. Likes, comments, shares, all that stuff really does help out the channel, and I would appreciate that. If you want to support me in any way, you can use any of the affiliate links down below or over at my webpage, tacticalconsiderations.com. That's pretty much how I keep the channel going, along with my Patreons. They are a huge support structure for the channel. I thank each and every one of you, and I appreciate all the support and help and conversations that we've had since you have all been a part of Patreon. Get out there and have some fun on the range. Remember, if you stay ready, you ain't got to get ready. I will see you all on the next one.